Hello, how's it going? My name is Jeremiah Nickel, a.k.a. JT Nickel on Reddit, at ProDJKC on Twitter. Just a quick announcement that we are going to be helping out EY once again as a major participant in the Global Blockchain Summit, May 18th through the 21st. The event is free. It's an educational summit. It's different than anything you've seen before, as there are plenty of breakout workshops in the works. Another idea that I've had that's getting tossed around right now is to issue POAPs for this event. We are in communications with the POAP team and Patricio, namely, to issue POAPs for a variety of things within the summit. We hope that that happens. It's not my final say. I'm just throwing it out there. In full disclosure, no member or myself of the Ethfinance team is accepting payment from EY. The only thing is, we at some point when we go back in person, EY would like to fly me out there and hang out, and I think that would be fun. So just to let you know, in full disclosure, there's no payments being made. I'm not a vendor or anything like that. We just help as a part of the goodwill of the community, as we've always done for every other conference that wants the same level of exposure. So another idea that I've got floating around in my head, these are my ideas and my ideas alone. These are not in progress at all. But we've been approached in terms of money by various people that, you know, the Ethfinance moderator team does a good job. We should be compensated for this. We will not take any money whatsoever for the work that we do. This is just community credibility and social contract, you know, with everybody to help curate the best information we can find. It's you that curates the information. It's us that takes out the trash. And so I did have an idea, though, and this is very long-term thinking, and would include EY, would be to set up a scholarship fund through Gitcoin and some kind of multi-signature trust that if enough money was raised, that money could be reinvested into the ecosystem in terms of gaining interest. The principal that is raised, the ETH or whatever that is raised, is locked up. Okay, it's not just immediately dumped on the market and scholarships are distributed. I think it would be more long-term thinking if enough money was raised. That money could be put to work, either staking or what have you, and the dividends off the top of that are scraped off annually to help provide scholarship opportunities specifically for students in computer sciences and software wanting to work in the Ethereum blockchain ecosystem. So in my thoughts, this is not geared towards outgoing high school seniors. This is going to be geared towards junior level and seniors in college that are, or graduate degree students that definitely have a focused interest in solidity development or what have you. And then we would have to seek out universities, I think, that would suit that ability. But here's the thing, with contributing to that, a POAP could be issued. The POAP that you hold in your wallet is proof that you contributed to the scholarship fund. And then annually, we could ask the stakeholders, the people that own the POAPs, to help in the selection process. And those students that are then selected, who knows, we could have, like I work for Grid Plus, they could have a swag bag with the Lattice One in there, or some safeguards, or what have you. There could be a variety of institutional and enterprise level people that are contributing to this scholarship fund, along with the Ethfinance community. So those POAPs and proof of attendance in helping out with this, I think would just be a pretty big game changer, that not only are you donating to something, your money is not getting immediately sold, it's getting put to work, and you have a final say in the candidates. And the candidates then get real feedback from the people that are donating to them specifically. It's a race to get this scholarship. There's going to be some competition to win this thing. And a lot of the cool things that'll come out of this is that you've got a candidate that is definitely plugged in to the end goal. And then you've also got all the people like EY, the companies that are in there, they get to watch these students progress through their studies. So it's really kind of a neat little one-to-one trustless way of focusing the money where it needs to go, and also reciprocating, from the student back to the ecosystem. It's just, it's a thought. Administratively, I have no bandwidth for, you know, spearheading it. I don't know the financial side of it. I don't understand the legal side of it. This is where we're going to need some help. And I'm assuming that EY probably has an entire department dedicated to scholarship funds, so they could, you know, the administration side of things could be maybe in their hands. What do you think about that? How does that pan out in your mind? Put your comments on Reddit in the comments below this video. And thanks so much for considering joining us for the conference in May. Very much looking forward to seeing all of you there. It is free. Again, it's free. And they've got a huge panel that's going to be put together. There's going to be more information in the weeks ahead. In fact, you can probably hit the link right up in the top of the daily on the daily thread. We've got some information ready to go for the three-day workshops for the EY Global Blockchain Summit. That's all I got. Cheers and big hugs from Kansas City. Man, it's Friday. Are you guys excited? I'm excited. Cheers.